Now, in this video, you will see the change in color of different indicators. Here I have taken methyl orange, here I have taken phenolphthalein, then red litmus, blue litmus, and pH paper, or you say it is called as universal indicator. PS paper is also called as universal indicator. So we see how they are and how they behave. First of all, I would like to introduce you with the litmus papers and litmus solution. See children, here it is there, it is red litmus. This is red litmus paper, red. The strips are now slightly lighted, or you can say dark pink in color. This is red litmus. Now coming to other one, it is C. It is what? It is blue litmus paper, and as name indicates, it is having blue in color. So this is there. Now coming to third, about the pH paper or universal indicator. So this is, you know, pH paper or universal indicator. So there is the standard reference table. Reference are, this starts from 1 and here it ends up to, you know, 7. Another pattern there is, you know, the pH from 8 to, you know, 14. 8 to 14. And see the color. This is universal indicator, and so it is slightly, you know, it is light yellow in color. So this is about the three different types of testing. Now coming to then C, this is methyl orange. C, this is methyl orange. As name indicates, it is an indicator, methyl orange. So we'll see what is the change in color. Again, see here we have phenolphthalein. So see, this is phenolphthalein. This is phenolphthalein, and phenolphthalein, you know, it is what? It is colorless. It is just like water. Then coming to again litmus solution. This is, you know, litmus solution. Litmus solution. It is what? It is red in color. It is written red in color. Then coming to again same blue litmus. So this is litmus solution, blue in color. Then here I have taken for you people. Here this is dilute sulfuric acid. Dilute sulfuric acid. This I have taken glass rod for the convenience. Then here I have taken sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide for the testing. What is the change in color? Then we'll see how there is change in the color, and then of course we'll have this. Now we'll start with the, you know, first I am taking out. So very simple. We hold like this and take one strip of, you know, see, this is, I am going to tear it out, hold and then take out. This is simple. This is, you know, what? It is blue litmus color. Now I am going to put, this is sodium hydroxide, this is sodium hydroxide, and I am going to take with the help of this glass rod on this side. See, this sodium hydroxide, no change, it remains as it is. So it is not a basic indicator. Now I am going to see this acid, dilute sulfuric acid. See, I am going to put here this. See the change in color. See change in color. So what is there? That this blue litmus, it is acidic indicator. So here if you say blue litmus, so here it is in terms of this changes to red. Changes to red. And in basis it is no change. So what you can say, blue litmus, it is what? It is acidic indicator. Blue litmus is acidic indicator. This is acidic indicator. So this is about the, you know, blue litmus. Now coming to red litmus. See, Just very simple. Flip over the safety paper and take out one strip carefully. Again, I will do in the same manner. Just hold in the center. Just hold in the center. And here I will apply, you know, a drop of what? This sodium hydroxide. This sodium hydroxide. This sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. Again, I am going to put this sodium hydroxide here. See the color. Now I am going to take this, what, the sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid, and here I apply this. It means there is no change in color. No change in color. So here this real litmus, here with the acid, no change. It remains as it is. It is no change, but here it changes to blue. Blue color. Blue color. Here changes to red. And here we will write down the summary. Summary in the next. So here, this real litmus, red litmus, no change with the acid, and it changes to, so it is what? It is basic indicator. It is basic indicator. Here it is, you know, it is acidic indicator. It is acidic indicator. So this is about the, you know, litmus. So again, there can be, you know, different conditions. Then coming to this methyl orange, we'll have this methyl orange. So simply, we can take the phenolphthalein also. So take, you know, any piece of paper or filter paper. See how here I have taken a small piece of filter paper, and here I have taken this, you know, again sulfuric acid, and we have the sodium hydroxide also. So this is the sulfuric acid dilute, and here there is the, you know, sodium hydroxide. Now I am going to put drop of, you know, this is sodium hydroxide on one side, and on other side, just, you know, economy is best. Just I have taken this, you know, this acid on drop. Now this phenolphthalein, just I am going to put over this. See, it changes to what? It changes to pink. It changes to pink. Phenolphthalein changes to pink by base. On acid, see, no change. On acid, there is no change in color. See on this side, no change in color. So what we can say, that phenolphthalein, here acid, no change, and base, it is changing to pink. So summary, it will be basic indicator. It means acids, they are unable to change the color of this phenolphthalein. Again, I am going to do the same. Here, I am putting a drop of sodium hydroxide here, and here I am putting drop of here acid. Just same. Now I am going to take, see, children, this what? This is methyl orange. The name indicates methyl orange. It has orange color. And so see here. Here, there is change in color. Is it change in color? No. On about this. See. The color remains as it is in basic. But it changes to, you know, pink. So here, a methyl orange with acid, it changes to pink. Changes to pink, and here no change. It means summary will be, it will be what? It will be acidic indicator. It will be acidic indicator. So this is, you know, it is methyl orange changes the colorless acid. Colorless acid. Again, you can see here just this, you know, this sulfuric acid here. Again, I am repeating. See here. This is, you know, colorless. Colorless. I am going to put this. See. This differentiates. See, upper portion, it is, you know, orange. And this central portion and this, it has turned pink. So this is the, you know, changes to pink, and so this is there about the now coming last about the PHCM. So here I have taken strip of the universal indicator, and here this sodium hydroxide, this is universal indicator or simply pH, and so see here it changes to, you know, it changes to blue, dark blue. And we can compare, we can compare with the strip, the strip of the pH. See here, compare, see the strip, compare, the pH is, you know, it is around the last one, this last one, it is, see, this is how much it is around, you know, 14. Then I am going to take this another strip, and see here, I have taken sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid, just applying a draw. See the color change. See the color change. It has changed to, you know, pink. Now compare. This is the reference level. Compare this. So this pH, the color, see, pH is how much? pH is, you know, it is around 1. So this is the way how we use the different indicators by changing color. And so this is there to study about the indicators. Similarly, other indicators like olfactory indicators, like onion, garlic, you know, vanilla, there is a change in color, in acidic color as well as a smell in the acidic end. Similarly, cloves are there, cardamom is there, all the aromatic substances, they respond the change in a smell behavior or color behavior in presence of acid or base, and so they are called as olfactory indicators. Basically, olfactory means related to a smell. So at last, the conclusion part. So first, there is the methyl orange, and in presence of acid, it changes to pink. Base, no effect, no change in color, it remains, you know, as it is, remains orange. So it is acidic indicator. Coming to second, phenolphthalein. So acid, no change. In base, changes to pink. Summary, it is basic indicator. Then red litmus, in acid, no change. In base, it changes to blue, so it is basic indicator. Similarly, blue litmus, acid changes to red. So blue litmus changes to red, so it is, you know, acidic indicator. In base, no change, so it is acidic indicator. Then coming to, you know, pH paper or phenolphthalein. So this presence of acid, pink. Pink in presence of base, it is, you know, blue. So the pink color or the blue color intensity, very important point. In case of dilute acids, the strength of pink color is very dense. Then as the strength of acidic character decreases, it becomes orange and becomes light orange, it becomes yellow. This is it. Similarly, in case of basic, so, you know, the solution having pH of 7, it is light green in color. So as the concentration of hydroxyl ions increases, the blue color strength increases. So last will be the dark blue color. If it is 14, dark blue. If it is 13, there will be a light blue, then less light blue. So this is there, and so this is the complete study about the different indicators and the different parameters.